Hello and welcome to the big picture. The reshuffle of portfolios undertaken by Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, involving three ministers, all incidentally belonging to the Congress party, with the monsoon session just a week away, has evoked mixed reactions. The three portfolios involved, finance, home and power, are obviously very important ones. And the ministers who have been shuffled has led to various interpretations about the exercise. After the elevation of the finance minister Pranab Mukherjee to Rashtrapati Bhavan, there were speculations that Prime Minister would keep the portfolio for some time with himself. But obviously, he did not want to. The return of P.Chidambaram to finance ministry has been welcomed in certain quarters, while some quarters view it with skepticism. What has, however, evoked the sharpest reaction is the choice of Sushil Kumar Shinde as the home minister, especially after two disastrous days in the history of this country when half of the country went without power, a portfolio he held till yesterday. Veerappa Moily, who was underutilized as corporate affairs minister, now has got the additional charge of power and gets a good opportunity to prove his administrative efficiency in reforming the power sector, which is very badly needed. What are the implications of this reshuffle? Was it timed right? How will the opposition take this? Will it improve the overall efficiency of the UPA government? And also, how do the allies of the government view it? We will look at all this while asking the question, will the reshuffling of ministers improve UPA government's performance? To discuss this, I have an interesting panel of guests. D.P.Tripathy, Rajya Sabha member from the NCP, a key component of the UPA government, Prakash Javadekar, BJP spokesman, Nilotpal Basu, CPIM Central Committee member, and Vinod Sharma, political editor of Hindustan Times. Welcome to all of you. Let me come to you, Mr. Tripathy, first. Mr. Tripathy, do you see this reshuffle as something which was necessary and needed at this point of time?
I think so, because the Prime Minister cannot have too many portfolios with him. Even when the Parliament session is to commence very soon, you need effective hands to handle various departments in the government. And I think Mr. Shinde's choice as Home Minister will bring experience and confidence to the government. He has been Chief Minister of Maharashtra for and Minister for so many years, Governor and Minister at the centre, and he will contribute quite a lot as a very distinguished parliamentarian and legislator in Maharashtra. So, and Mr. Chidambaram have held the finance portfolio. He is aware of the various complex issues which are facing the finance ministry, especially in the context of the global economic meltdown. And Indian economy needs a lot of focus and new avenues of strength to resuscitate our economy. Therefore, I believe the additional charge of power given to Mr. Moily, again, a very, very experienced minister and who had been Chief Minister of Karnataka. So, I think for the first time, you have this reshuffle, which is full of experience, sagacity, and therefore hope.
It is very interesting, Mr. Tripathy, that you have said the kind of words, the good words which you have said about Mr. Sushil Kumar Shinde. There was a lot of speculation, in fact, that it was your party which was not too keen on his elevation. But you seem to be saying it's completely opposite.
Mr. Nikam, that's not correct. And how can we decide about elevation of the Congress ministers and things like that? We are part of the coalition. Okay. And we welcome this, actually.
Okay. Mr. Javadekar, the BJP has not taken too kindly to the elevation or, shifting of Mr. Chidambaram to the finance ministry. Don't you think there is the prerogative of the Prime Minister to shift the ministers to whichever ministry he wants?
Yes, this is the prerogative of the Prime Minister. But our reaction is from the people's side,
and people are of the country are not enthused about such reshuffles because you are just playing the musical chairs. It is not the issue of capacity as far as Chidambaram is concerned.
Right.
It is the issue of propriety. As you know, day after tomorrow, the Supreme Court will hear about the appeal as far as Chidambaram's role in 2G case,
right,
as alleged by Mr. Subramanian Swamy.
Right.
So there is one issue, and the same ministry is heading. The another issue is the latest CBI revelation before the committee that it was Aircel Maxis deal which is malafide, and such a malafide deal, how it got the FIPB approval. So these are the valid issues which we have raised earlier, and we are raising it again because that makes it the issue of propriety.
Mr.
As far as Sushil Kumar Shinde is concerned, we have no personal grudge against. We are friends.
Right.
The issue is he has failed miserably, and latest is the power grid failure, which is the central domain issue, not the state drawl as he wants to make us believe. And so the same day he gets elevation, so that is the issue we raise, that is the public reaction.
Okay.
And as far as Veerappa Moily, as now he is the minister on transfer, so he was law minister, then he becomes minister, then so he occupies everything that is needed. So this is what is our reaction is.
Okay.
It doesn't enthuse, and there may be lot many good young talents also, but as far as till the Rahul Gandhi's role is decided in the governance, no youngsters will be elevated to important positions.
Anyway, that's a completely separate issue, Mr. Javadekar.
Politics, which we have said.
Okay, no, let me get back to Mr. Tripathy and Mr. Tripathy. Two issues raised about the two ministers. Oh. Don't you think they are valid issues, valid points which Mr. Javadekar has?
No. As opposition leader, Mr. Javadekar is fully authorized to raise those issues. There's nothing wrong about it, but as far as we are concerned, we have expressed our position clearly. And you tell me, in the given situation, just look at the Council of Ministers. Who could have been more qualified and experienced to occupy the Home Ministry at this juncture? Who would have been more qualified to occupy Finance Ministry at this juncture? At this point of time, you cannot even say that giving additional charge to Veerappa Moily, Mr. Veerappa Moily, is in any way wrong.
Okay.
It is all welcome change in the Council of Ministers through this reshuffle. Actually, this is a reallocation of portfolio.
Reallocation, absolutely. Anyway, it's very interesting that you're defending this whole thing so much. Despite the fact that none of the allies have been, there is nothing which has happened as far as the allies are concerned. Anyway, I'll come back to you. Nilotpal, what is yours and your party's stand on this? Do you think that the Mr. Chidambaram coming back to the finance ministry, as I said, anyway, this is a prerogative of the prime minister, but what is your reaction to this?
I think overall, this UPA, two governments, about these governments, the public perception is so negative. And with the shuffling of this pack of cards, it's very difficult to really regain the momentum of the government. I think it's a mere coincidence that we have today as finance minister, about whom there are certain aspects which are being gone into by the courts, and I don't know whether there is an issue of conflict of interest involved. I mean, that is for some legal mind to look into that. And as you said yourself, that this whole disastrous situation in power, whether that qualifies Mr. Shinde. And the other thing about Mr. Moily. Now, I think what this government needs is really a major shift in the policy, a midterm appraisal. Only that could perhaps enthuse the people, because so far as the economy is concerned and the food price situation is concerned and the Aam Aadmi's concerns are concerned, we are in a very, very difficult situation. And Chidambaram's economic philosophy, if it is something to go by, has shown a complete question mark on the basis of what is happening in the West, in North America, or countries of Europe. So I don't think that unless the government actually thinks in terms of making some midterm appraisal and policy shift, I mean, anyway, the sinking fortunes of this government can be restored. And I think Mr. D.P.Tripathy also gave himself away with that slightly mischievous smile and this reference to what could he possibly say about the reshuffle involving the Congress party, because I think he's now more concerned about showing to the people that the solidity of this coalition.
But anyway, coming to Vinod, the question of timing, the question of timing of this reallocation of portfolios, just as we all of them were pointing out, and you know, bringing Mr. Shinde to the Home Ministry just on the day when his ministry and he seemed to have completely failed in managing the power situation.
So you'd have to take a holistic view. I'm not a great admirer of Mr. Shinde or anybody else, you know, but you'll have to take a holistic view. You'll have to see what kind of augmentation of has happened in the power sector during the period he was the power minister. And this, the Northern Grid tripping, indeed, I mean, you may argue that he's looking for excuses when he says that this tripping happened because some certain states were overdrawing.
Right.
But the fact is that certain states do overdraw, and that is absolutely what leads to problems. Now, it was an engineering failure, it was a maintenance failure, it was a failure indeed under his watch as the top man where the buck stops in the power ministry. But, you know, he couldn't be sort of, you can't expect a minister to sort of go with a toolbox and start fixing the Northern Grid. I am not for a moment suggesting that there is something which can be condoned or overseen.
His
look, Mr. Shinde, you can have 20 things to criticize him. For instance, I would personally feel that Mr. Shinde is not the kind of strong personality that you need in the Home Ministry. By the same time, you will have to recognize the fact that Mr. Shinde has been former chief minister, as pointed out by Mr. D.P.Tripathy, and the opposition should be happy that if a former chief minister becomes home minister, the center state issues would get a better hearing from that man, because he has been also at the other at the receiving end as chief minister.
Right.
So I think that there is a lot of scope for criticism in these changes that have been brought about. Nilotpal said that this government requires a paradigm shift in policy terms. The shift may not be the kind of shift the left perhaps expects, and many of us expect. But surely one expects that the Prime Minister takes the lead. He may have given the Finance Ministry to Mr. Chidambaram, but the onus for repairing the economy is squarely on the Prime Minister himself.
Okay. Let me go back to Mr. Tripathy. Mr. Tripathy, there were problems between your party and the Congress party. We saw what had happened in the last 1 week. But now things, you think this was this kind of reallocation of portfolio, and you people did not expect to be part of this reallocation, or do you expect this to happen at a future date? What was the final solution which made you people, your ministers, come back to the cabinet and for normalcy to be restored?
No. See, there was no expectation as far as we are concerned. As far as the alliance partners are concerned, as you are talking about our differences, it was on policy issues. It was on the question of running the coalition.
Right.
Now that the coordination committee has been agreed upon and there will be a proper sort of coordination mechanism, and there will be consultation at least once a month among the constituent parties on policy and other issues, I think this will strengthen the UPA.
So this allocation, this reallocation of portfolios, which has been confined only to the Congress party, does not really bother you people. Is that what you're trying to say? Or do you expect you people to be, you and other allies of the UPA, to be, you know, justice to be done at another time, maybe after the parliament session?
Well, that is up to the Prime Minister. This is prerogative of the Prime Minister, even in the coalition government, to constitute his Council of Ministers and allocate portfolios according to his plans and perspective. So this is the constitutional position, and we as constituent party of UPA respect this constitutional position.
Okay, Mr. Tripathy, thank you for joining us. I'm told that you have to leave. Thank you very much. We will go into a short break now. We'll come back soon and continue this discussion. Welcome back. We are discussing the reallocation of portfolios of key ministers and looking at how it will affect or improve the performance of the UPA government. Mr. Javadekar, these kind of reallocations and reshuffles are something which is part of every government. Your government has also been part of it. Now, as far as the performance of the ministers, now let us see. Do you see that reallocation, these ministers have been rewarded for their good work, or how do you see this?
I really don't want to say much about this, because this is literally an internal matter of the Congress, because it is a ruling party heading the ruling coalition, and it is their portfolios, ministers, which they are changing. But as I told you, people, ultimately in democracy, what matters are the people. And people are not enthused with this exercise. What is today hurting the country is the complete policy paralysis. And the momentum of growth has slowed down.
That is exactly
and
the point.
That doesn't give any indication.
That is exactly the point, Mr. Javadekar. Bringing back somebody like Mr. Chidambaram, who is an old hand in the finance ministry, don't you think should help the economy in the larger context?
Let me tell you, he became Home Minister on the backdrop of 26-11.
Absolutely.
And after he becoming Home Minister, he has done some steps, he has taken some steps. But let us not forget the 9 terror attacks which happened afterwards, 7 are still unresolved.
Right.
So, I don't blame only one person for that, but that shows the whole paralysis which has crept in the government machinery. And that is what is ailing the country. You need a leader with ideas, leader with some dynamism, and the Prime Minister has to give them that free hand, and the Prime Minister must get the free hand.
Okay, let me go to Nilotpal. Nilotpal, bringing back Chidambaram to the Finance Ministry, and this hopes which have been, you see, at least in the corporate circles, in the financial circles, people are quite enthused by it. Even stock market apparently showed some enthusiasm to that. The fact is that here is a man who has come back to the finance ministry, but does it also not reflect this enthusiasm upon the serious differences within the government when Mr. Pranab Mukherjee was the finance minister?
I think more than that, what is happening, Girish, is because of the overall performance of this government, the perception is very, very negative among the people. You may be an expert about corporate mind. I am not so.
I just go by what I read and what I hear.
I prefer to see it from the people's standpoint. You see, And that performance is so bad. I mean, why you are talking only of terrorism? The question is, just the other day we had this huge and disastrous fratricidal riots in Assam. We had been having all these problems of over-enthusiasm on the question of Maoists, but nothing happened thereafter, and the problems are simmering. So I think overall the grasp of this government on issues pertaining to people, you look at the fiasco on the Telangana question, and so on and so forth. So this overall perception about the government is also getting reflected in the individual performance of each of the ministries. And there, I think, as I am saying, what is of greater importance is a clear-cut policy position to address the concerns of the people. Okay. The price situation.
Okay.
What is happening? Not only the former finance minister who is now occupying Rashtrapati Bhavan, but the prime minister himself, time and again, giving commitment about taming the price situation, but it is spinning out of control. The food situation, the poverty situation in the country, the overall economic outlook of the country, all these does not inspire any confidence among the people.
Okay.
And therefore, where we should really concentrate on that, what is the approach that the government should take? Because, you see, it's true that we are in the opposition, but at the same time, this government is also our government. We would like to see this government fulfill its electoral commitment in terms of addressing the concerns
Absolutely.
Of the Aam Aadmi.
Okay. Vinod, When a prime minister undertakes this kind of exercise, this was inevitable because, you know, here was a finance minister who was seen as man for all seasons, suddenly moves to Rashtrapati Bhavan, there is a huge vacuum created in the cabinet. The prime minister had few options. You think he could have looked outside the cabinet to fill some of these posts, or do you think he had no other option than what he has done?
You see, when Mr. Chidambaram, and I would like to slightly disagree with my friend Nilotpal, he was the finance minister also of the Gowda government, which was very strongly backed by the left parties. Mm. And which was working virtually on the advice of the left parties. So Mr. Chidambaram was moved out of the finance ministry, not because he was branded a failure in the finance ministry, because it was felt that he would be a better choice for the home ministry in place of Mr. Shivraj Patil. Insofar as power ministry is concerned, like the rail ministry is virtually monopoly of Bihar, power ministry is the monopoly of Maharashtra. Because
of Bihar and West Bengal.
West Bengal, and power ministry is the monopoly of Maharashtra, and that's why Javadekar is so soft and so happy, you know. Because there was Suresh Prabhu and thereafter Anant Gite, and now you had Mr. Shinde. So, I think that if there is a failure on the power front, I think Maharashtra, where Bombay never gets any power cuts, these people have not been able to transfer that technology to the center.
Mr.
And for the Javadekar, rest of the state.
Would you like to respond
but
to this?
But in just and in light way, and I'm saying this, I'm saying it in a lighter way, not as a serious comment. What I foresee is that post-monsoon session, this government should and may undertake a personality transplant. And that may entail a whole lot of younger ministers being given bigger responsibilities, being asked to handle portfolios independently. And that is where you may find Mr. Moily being dispossessed of the power portfolio, because that's concurrent charge. His main charge is corporate affairs. And you may have a younger face handling the power ministry, as was in the Vajpayee government, until Mr. Thackeray decided to remove a very good, a very competent minister, Mr. Suresh Prabhu, because it was his prerogative. These three ministries were with the Congress, and it was the Prime Minister's prerogative to appoint whoever he wanted to. Yes, of course, these appointments, as Mr. Javadekar says, as Nilotpal says, maybe short
expectations. My short question to you, Vinod, is, can this be seen as rewards for their performance, or is it just political adjustments which
there is a political message
behind this?
This is a politically expedient These changes are politically expedient changes. These changes are not the changes which may come as the first choice. But because, you know, Javadekar said that it's a game of musical chairs. Indeed, it is a game of musical chairs. In every government, it has been a game of musical chairs. I haven't seen any government in my memory where in the middle of the term, you chuck out half of the cabinet and bring in new people from outside. Because where is the talent, you know? So you have to make do with whatever human resource is available with you.
Let me go to Mr. Javadekar. Mr. Javadekar, is this also a problem of talent? It happens with every government. Your government has seen this. Your state governments will, you know, continue to see this.
Regional balance has also to be there.
Yes.
You know, you may have 5, 6, 7 very talented people from a particular state, but you cannot appoint all of them.
I would like both Mr. Javadekar and Nilotpal Basu to quickly respond to this point which has been raised by Vinod Sharma. First, very interesting points. Yes, Mr. Javadekar.
Vinod Sharma has actually vindicated what I was saying, that there may be good talented youngsters, but they are not accommodated till the placement of Rahul Gandhi is decided finally. You don't know when it will be. But no, because that is very important.
Okay, we don't know, but this happens, is just speculation.
Nobody will be allowed to take important charge.
No, this is just,
but that is one. So he is agreed to my point. And as far as the musical chair comment is concerned, very clear. When you have, as he has also accepted, when you have very limited choice, you just shuffle the cards.
Right.
But makes no sense as far as the people are concerned.
Absolutely. Mr. Nilotpal Basu, the problem of, you know, having talent, is that one of the problems which do you agree with Vinod Sharma on that? That there's limited talent available?
You see, I need not answer this question. In fact, Vinod Sharma, who is generally very supportive of the government's moves, has made this point very clear. There's an English adage which says beggars cannot be choosers. Now, overall perception about this government is so poor that, therefore they have made whatever choices they have made. And we are barking at the wrong tree. The main problem is with the policy approach of this government. Unless that changes,
policy approach,
it will not go down well with the people.
We will see, Nilotpal, because these new ministers who have come, Vinod, policy approach, policy changes, do you expect to happen at least in the finance ministry?
You see, I think that, you know, Nilotpal says that, you know, I'm generally supportive of the government. But the government often accuses me of being supportive of this left parties, you know.
You please.
And no, n number of issues.
Vinod, you replied to my...
The left has now made it a...
Do you expect...
to a level of state-of-the-art technology to annoy even the supporters. But nevertheless, that's their choice.
Vinod, do you expect...
That's their choice.
Vinod, do you expect major... Do you expect any major...
There will be, according to me, and if... I mean, I can go wrong because, you know, one is only making an intelligent guess and based on second and third and information which one gets, that there should be a cabinet reshuffle of a sizable nature post the monsoon session. Whether or not there'd be a policy shift of the choice made, of the choices of the left parties, I do not know.
Okay.
But surely this government, the UPA government, has tried to make certain investments in the development sector.
Okay.
And that is where I think the left's pressure will work if they continue to mount the pressure.
Okay. So this limited reshuffle of, or rather reallocation of portfolios, may not see any major changes in the immediate in immediate future. But as Vinod Sharma says, if a bigger reallocation or reshuffle of portfolios is expected after the monsoon session, probably then we will see probably some changes which may become very necessary as the UPA government goes into an election mode next year. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks to all my guests, Mr. Prakash Javadekar, Nilotpal Basu, Vinod Sharma, and also Mr. D.P.Tripathy, who was with us. Thank you very much. Please keep watching. We'll come back with another issue on The Big Picture the same time tomorrow.